Hi, this is Ajay Anand and welcome to science classes from excelup.com. In this video, you will learn the solution of NCERT exercise questions from the chapter Life Processes, and this chapter and these questions they have been taken from Science of Class 10. Let us begin with question number 1. Question 1 is, the kidneys in human beings are part of a system for nutrition, respiration, excretion and transportation. So answer is straightforward. This is excretion, because by the time you reach class 10th, all of you must remember that kidney is a part of the excretory system. Second question is, the xylem in plants is responsible for transport of water, transport of food, transport of amino acid and transport of oxygen. The answer is A, transport of water. Question 3. Autotrophic mode of nutrition requires carbon dioxide and water, B, chlorophyll, C, sunlight, and option D is all of these. So the answer is all of these, because carbon dioxide is required for photosynthesis, water is required, sunlight is necessary for supplying energy, and chlorophyll is the site where photosynthesis takes place, chlorophyll converts, utilizes solar energy for photosynthesis. Question 4. The breakdown of pyruvate to give carbon dioxide, water and energy takes place in cytoplasm, mitochondria, chloroplast or nucleus. The answer is mitochondria. So this can be confusing for many of you. You should always remember that the breakdown of glucose up to pyruvic acid, that is later on becomes pyruvate, takes place in cytoplasm, and rest of the steps of cellular respiration, they take place in mitochondria, where pyruvic acid is further broken down in order to produce energy. Question 5. How are fats digested in our body? Where does this process take place? You may recall that most of the digestion takes place in small intestine, and that is where digestion of fat takes place. The digestion of fat happens in two steps. The first step is emulsification of fat by bile. Bile breaks down fat into small particles, so that it becomes easier for enzymes to act on fat. And after that, in step 2, lipase is the enzyme which works on fat. So first of all, lipase converts fat into di or monoglycerides, and after that lipase converts these glycerides, di and monoglycerides, into fatty acid and glycerol. So these are the end products of digestion of fat, fatty acid and glycerol. Question 6. What is the role of saliva in digestion of food? Saliva plays two important roles. One is the role is in lubrication. Saliva makes the food more slippery, and so that it becomes easier to swallow the food. So you can recall, you may have experienced that while eating some dry food stuff, like maybe a dry slice of bread, it may get stuck in your throat, or you may find it uncomfortable while swallowing the bread. But once you take it along with a gulp of water or any other liquid, it becomes easier to swallow the food. So saliva adds more liquid, adds lubricant to the food, and it becomes easier to swallow. Then there is an enzyme in saliva, and that is called salivary amylase. In some books you will read it as ptyalin also. The spelling is ptyalin, ptyalin. So salivary amylase, it works on starch and converts starch into sucrose. Question 7. What are the necessary conditions for autotrophic nutrition, and what are its byproducts? So necessary conditions, they were in the multiple choice question. So sunlight, carbon dioxide, water, and chlorophyll. These are the necessary factors or conditions for photosynthesis to take place. And the byproduct is the product which is not utilized by plants. So byproduct is oxygen, which is given out through stomata. Question 8. What are the differences between aerobic and anaerobic respiration? Name some organisms that use anaerobic respiration. In case of aerobic respiration, it takes place in presence of oxygen, and that is why this is called aerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration takes place in absence of oxygen. Complete oxidation of glucose takes place in aerobic respiration, but in case of anaerobic respiration, there is incomplete oxidation of glucose. Carbon dioxide is the end product in aerobic respiration, and in anaerobic respiration, apart from carbon dioxide, lactic acid or ethanol, they are also produced. Aerobic respiration is more efficient because of complete utilization, so there is more energy is produced per molecule of glucose, which is not in the case in case of anaerobic respiration. So there is less energy per molecule of glucose. Examples of organisms which use aerobic respiration are humans, plants, birds, reptiles, almost all the complex animals and plants. Anaerobic respiration is used by microbes like yeast and some bacteria. Question 9. How are alveoli designed to minimize exchange of gases? This figure shows the structure of alveoli. The shape of alveoli is spherical, and because of spherical shape, it gives maximum area in the minimum possible volume. That is the quality of sphere. So this gives maximum surface area for exchange of gases. The wall of alveoli, there it is thin, and because of thin wall, exchange of gases becomes easier. Alveoli, they are richly supplied with blood capillaries, and what happens during exchange of gases in alveoli, carbon dioxide goes out of blood and oxygen gets in the blood. So more blood will be there for exchange of gases. Question 10. What would be the consequences of deficiency of hemoglobin? Hemoglobin carries oxygen, and that oxygen reaches the cell wall where respiration takes place to provide energy to cells and in turn tissues and organs. So in case of deficiency of hemoglobin, less amount of oxygen will reach cells. So cells will not be in a position to produce the required energy. So a person suffering from hemoglobin deficiency will feel lethargic. He will readily get tired. He won't be able to do work which involves a lot of physical labor. So these are the problems. Question 11. Describe double circulation in human beings, and why is it necessary? This figure shows a heart, the way most of the people draw. especially the teenagers. This is the right side of the heart and this is the left side of the heart. What happens in one cardiac cycle, blood passes through the heart twice. Once, this is the circulation of deoxygenated blood as shown by purple color, and second is the circulation of oxygenated blood. So since there are two distinct circulations in one cardiac cycle through the human heart, hence this is called double circulation. Double circulation ensures that oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood, they never get to mix with each other. And so this is a more efficient method of circulation of blood in the animal's body. Now, mammals and birds, they are warm-blooded animal. Okay, so they need more energy in order to maintain their body temperature. The warm-blooded animals, they can maintain their body temperature, while cold-blooded animals, they adjust, their body temperature depends on the environment. Okay, so because of more energy need, the birds and mammals, they need a better and efficient system of blood circulation, and this double circulation provides efficiency so that they can easily get the energy to maintain their body temperature. Question 12. What are the differences between transport of materials in xylem and phloem? Xylem transports water and minerals, but phloem transports food. Transport through xylem, it happens because of physical forces like osmosis, diffusion, then capillary action, where energy is not required. And the movement of substances through xylem is unidirectional, that is in one direction, from roots to leaves. It does not take place in opposite direction. In case of phloem, energy is required for transporting the substances. So this is the big difference. Then the movement is bidirectional. So food can move from leaf to storage organ of a plant, and it can also move vice versa, that is from a storage organ of a plant to a new leaf, which may require more food in order to grow. Question 13. Compare the functioning of alveoli in the lungs and nephrons in kidneys with respect to their structure and functioning. Alveoli, they have thin membrane and they have rich supply of capillary. Nephrons have numerous cup-shaped structure and they are called Bowman's capsule, and highly convoluted tubules are present in nephron. Exchange of materials, that is exchange of gases in alveoli, takes place through diffusion. In case of kidney, exchange of material takes place because of high pressure, the ultrafiltration or filtration under ultra-high pressure, that is what it is called. In case of alveoli, oxygen enters the blood and carbon dioxide exits the blood. In case of nephrons, waste materials, they come out of the blood and they make urine. That's all for this lesson. Thank you.